We alone known about the 2042 Amendment Act brought in 1976 in the Indian Constitution. Actually, it is termed as a mini constitution. So I am going to summarize some facts why this Amendment Act is known as a mini constitution. What are the changes it has brought into the Indian Constitution? See, in the preamble, the words socialist, secular and integrated are added. The changes brought by the 42 Amendment Act, you can see the changes in the preamble made. Words socialist, secular and integrity have been added. Changes in 7th schedule also take place. Transferred 5 subjects from the state list to the concurrent list. Education, forests, weights and measures, protection of wild animals and birds, administration of justice. Article 51A has been added. In this, 10 fundamental duties have been incorporated. These are added for the citizens. The fundamental duties of citizens were added upon the recommendations of the Soren Singh Committee that was constituted by the government in 1976. This is an important point, remember. The fundamental duties of citizens were added upon the recommendations of the Soren Singh Committee that was constituted by the government in 1976. Then the changes made in the matters regarding to parliament, made president bound to the advice of the cabinet, allowed center to deploy central forces in state to deal with the conflicting situations of law and order, Article 257A, gave special discriminatory powers to the Speaker of Lok Sabha and Prime Minister, Article 329A, directive principles were given precedence over fundamental rights, and any law made to this effect by the parliament was kept beyond the scope of judicial review by the court. You can see this. Directive principles were given precedence over fundamental rights, and any law made to this effect by the parliament was kept beyond the scope of judicial review by the court. Judicial powers of High Court, change has been brought in this also, curtail the judicial review powers of the High Courts. Articles 323A, Article 323B and Part 14A, here the changes were also made. Part 14A added entitled as tribunals dealing with administrative matters and tribunals for other matters. Directive principles of state policies, in this 4 new DPSPs were included along with the existing list of DPSPs. See these 4 new points. To secure opportunities for the healthy development of children, Article 39. To promote equal justice and to provide free legal aid to the poor, Article 39A. To take steps to secure the participation of workers in management of the industries, Article 43A. To protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and wildlife, Article 48A. So these are the new directive principles of state policy have been incorporated in our constitution as a result of 42nd amendment. In our constitution. Also remember then 44 Amendment Act was introduced in the year 1978 by the government. This act was brought to nullify the amendments made by the 42 Amendment Act 1976. You can see also this is important point. So 44 Amendment. It reversed the provision made by the 42 Amendment Act that allowed the government to amend the constitution on its wish by Article 368. 44th Amendment Act nullified this unjustified power to the government. Second important point regarding 44 Amendment Act, removed right to property from the list of fundamental rights and made it a legal right. Third, previously the grounds for the declaration of national emergency were external aggression and internal disturbance, but the 44th Amendment replaced the word internal disturbances with the word armed rebellion. You can see this. Then Article 226 was amended to restore to the High Courts their power to issue writs for any other purpose besides the enforcement of fundamental rights. So, increment in the power of the High Court regarding their power to issue writs. 44th Amendment Act modified the constitutional emergency provisions and prevented them from being misused in the future. It restored the Supreme Court and High Court's jurisdiction and power which they enjoyed before the 42 Amendment Act was passed. It restored the secular and democratic ideas present in the Constitution. And, see this line. It restored the secular and democratic ideas present in the Indian Constitution. The 44th Amendment Act of 1978 added one more directive principle, which requires the state to minimize inequalities in income, state status, facilities and opportunities, Article 38. The 44th Amendment Act of 1978 added one more directive principle, which requires the state to minimize inequalities in income, status, facilities and opportunities. This is incorporated in Article 38. The 42 and the 44th Amendment Acts of 1976 and 1978 respectively have made the ministerial advice binding on the President. The 44th Amendment Act of 1978 introduced a new provision to put a restraint on the power of Parliament to extend the proclamation of president rules beyond 1 year. Thus, it provided that beyond 1 year, the president rules can be extended by 6 months at a time only when the following two conditions are fulfilled. The 44th Amendment of 1970 introduced a new provision to put a restraint on the power of Parliament to extend the proclamation of president rules beyond 1 year. Thus, it provided that beyond 1 year, the president rules can be extended by 6 months at a time only when the following two conditions are fulfilled. So, these are regarding our amendment number 42 and 44, brought in 1976 and 1978.